Is this the first DeepSeek moment in humanoid robotics? Today on AI News, we're looking at a brand new startup that claims its AI can perform all kinds of tasks autonomously. So is this real? And if so, how did they pull this off? Plus, stay to the end to see a new paradigm in robot learning. But first, let's take a look at this video from MindOn. And they say that this robot is completely autonomously controlled by their AI algorithms, not teleoperated. And something to note here is notice its agility when it steps up on top of this stair here. It moves with speed that we really haven't seen from many other robots. And is this using a vision language action system? Look at the way that it just steps right off. They're saying that they developed their own algorithm in-house. These are the former researchers from Tencent Robotics, which has inadvertently, inextricably become some kind of a startup accelerator for robotics, although Tencent itself does not have its own robotics initiative or robot that it's selling. But these researchers seem to have come a long way if this is indeed not teleoperated. This is one of the first genuinely useful demos that we've seen thus far. Although, notice that it is using a two-gripper hand, it would be interesting to see in future models if they can scale this out to a five-fingered dexterous hand. But so far, with just two fingers, it does a lot more than most five-fingered robots. And we can see that apparently it's safe around children, which would suggest that they've eliminated some of the pinch points here, probably, which is why they have it wearing this black suit to prevent any pinch points. And it would be interesting to know how long they actually trained this algorithm for and how much they spent on it. And tell me if you think this is the real deal or if it's a marketing ploy. But what about robots that can play, reason, and learn with you inside a 3D world to master the real world even faster? Before that, a message from today's sponsor. AI technology moves fast, and Opus Clip AI has been upgrading rapidly with major improvements to workflow automation for short-form content. It begins with automation. Auto-import pulls your latest YouTube videos and instantly auto-edits them into socially ready clips. Auto-scheduler lets creators bulk select and schedule content in advance, ensuring consistent posting even during vacations or offline periods, no manual intervention required. The editing experience has been completely reimagined. AI Editor 3.0 features a brand new interface that makes everything smoother and faster. With 15 new caption styles now available, creators have more creative flexibility for engagement. Reframe Anything 2.0 brings intelligent framing to a new level. Auto subject tracking automatically detects and reframes objects to keep them centered. Manual subject tracking gives creators control by letting them select specific objects for AI to track. And thanks Opus Clip for sponsoring this video. Click the link below to try it today. Meanwhile, Google is about to supercharge robot intelligence in the real world with its newest SEMA 2 AI that just learned to navigate virtual worlds by watching screens and controlling keyboards. In fact, DeepMind built SEMA 2 on top of last year's SEMA by integrating new reasoning capabilities that allow it to understand complex instructions, collaborate with users, and even improve through self-directed play across varying gaming environments. But SEMA 2's implications extend far beyond entertainment. That's because the skills it learned are some of the fundamental building blocks for physically embodying AI in the real world through robots. In fact, SEMA learned over 600 basic skills like turn left or climb the ladder across commercial video games, operating solely by observing screen pixels, and controlling virtual inputs with no access to the underlying game code. And this approach mirrors how robots perceive and interact with the physical world through sensors and actuators. Then, SEMA 2 integrated Google's Gemini language model to take it even further. This allowed the agent to reason about high-level goals, break them into steps, and explain its intentions to users. And this makes interactions feel less like issuing commands and more like collaborating with a thinking partner. In fact, it's this reasoning in particular that proves critical for robot applications, because rigid instruction following fails in unpredictable environments. So, for instance, a household robot can't just memorize a command like pick up the cup. Instead, it has to understand the intent and adapt to when the cup is different, the table is cluttered, or obstacles are in its way. But generalization is where SEMA 2 really stands out, successfully operating in games it never encountered before, including a Viking survival game, Aska, and Mind Dojo, which is a research version of Minecraft. But more importantly, it transfers learned concepts between contexts, like understanding that mining in one game relates to harvesting in another. This transfer learning directly addresses one of robotics' core challenges, which is that a robot trained to grasp objects in a laboratory has to still generalize these skills to kitchens, warehouses, and hospitals, where objects, lighting, and surfaces vary dramatically. And SEMA's performance is approaching human-level capability across diverse tasks, suggesting that human-level generalization is achievable. But SEMA 2's most striking test was when it was combined with Genie 3 to generate novel 3D worlds from images or text. Then, when placed in these completely new environments, SEMA 2 oriented itself to accomplish specific goals despite having zero prior experience, which is exactly the kind of adaptability that robots need when encountering unfamiliar spaces. But perhaps most significant for robotics development is SEMA 2's capacity for self-improvement. After initial human demonstrations, the agent was able to learn new games through autonomous trial and error, using Gemini-generated feedback to refine its approaches. Then, its own experience data was used to train subsequent versions, creating a virtuous cycle of improvement. And this kind of self-directed learning is exactly what could revolutionize robot training, because currently, teaching robots requires extensive human-labeled data for each new task, which is an expensive, time-consuming bottleneck. But if robots could learn through self-supervised exploration as SEMA 2 does, they could acquire new skills far faster and cheaper. And the researchers even leveraged this self-improvement in Genie-generated environments, demonstrating that agents could potentially train across infinite, synthetically created scenarios before ever touching physical hardware. Despite this progress, though, the researchers say there are still some limitations and remaining challenges. For one, SEMA 2 struggles with very long-horizon tasks that require extensive multi-step reasoning, maintaining only a limited amount of memory for past interactions in order to boost its performance. Meanwhile, precise low-level control and robust visual understanding of complex 3D scenes are two remaining research areas. Nevertheless, SEMA 2 suggests a future where general-purpose robots could learn their skills virtually before physical deployment, and then they could continue improving themselves with real-world experience. Anyways, like and subscribe, and thanks Opus Clip for sponsoring this video. Click the link below to try it today.